चैप्टर फोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स। अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स नाउ हियर मेन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स इन दिस चैप्टर। प्लेन सरफेस, प्लेन सरफेस, व्हाट इज प्लेन सरफेस? अ फ्लैट सरफेस लाइक पेपर इज अ प्लेन सरफेस। अ फ्लैट सरफेस like paper is a plane surface. You know that a paper you take, that is a plain paper, so that it is like it is flat. So flat surface, it is a plain surface. Or you can take table top, that is also plain. So that is that type, it is said to be a plane surface. Now plane curve, plane curve. When we get a curve by joining the number of points, when we get a curve by joining the number of points, now you see here, this is a one curve. Go, now here we are joining the points, then we got here curve. When we get a curve by joining the number of points without lifting the pencil is a plane curve. Without removing the pencil, without lifting the pencil, then we'll get a plane curve. For example, you see here, now once you touch start doing a line, if you start, then again like this, then leave it. So this is a one plane curve. So here also one plane curve, this also one plane curve. Okay. When we get a curve by joining the number of points, joining the number of points without lifting the pencil is a plane curve. Without removing the pencil is a plane curve. It could be an open or closed curve. It may be open curve or it may be closed curve. Now you see here, there are two types. One is open curve, another one is closed curve. This type of curves are said to be open curve. Now closed curve, now see, when one point, from one point you start, then after covering all this, then again it joins at the same starting point. So this type of it is said to be a closed curve. Once you start from here and after doing four line segment, then it reaches at the initial position, starting position. So this is said to be, this type of curves are said to be closed curve. Okay. Now here polygons, polygons, the simple closed curves which are made up of line segments only. The simple closed curves which are made up of line segments only are called the polygons. The simple closed curve, these are closed curves which are made up of line segment, line segment only are called the polygons. The simple closed curves which are made up of line segments only are called the polygons. Classification of polygons. Polygons can be classified by the number of sides or vertices they have. Number of sides 3, name of polygon triangle. So your figure, it is a triangle. So here how many sides are here? 1, 2, 3 sides. Okay, number of sides 3. How many vertices? This point is said to be vertex. To where two lines are joining, that point is said to be vertex. Plural of vertex is said to be vertices. 1, 2, 3. There are totally 3 vertices and 3 sides. Then this figure is said to be triangle. When if 4 sides are there, 4 sides are there, then it is said to be a quadrilateral. A figure which is bounded by 4 line segment is said to be a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral, 4 sides. Now here number of sides 5, then pentagon 1 2 3 4 5. So now how many sides? 5 sides are there. Then name of this polygon is said to be pentagon. Then if 6 sides are there, then it is said to be hexagon. Then it is said to be hexagon. Then if 7 sides are there, then it is said to be heptagon. Then it is said to be heptagon. If 8 sides are there, then it is said to be octagon. 8 sides, it is said to be octagon. If 9 sides is there, then it is said to be nonagon. If 10 sides are there, then it is said to be decagon. If n sides is there, then it is said to be n-gon. Okay. Next point, we'll go to diagonals. Any line segment which connects the two non-conjugative vertices. You know, conjugative means continuous vertices. Non-conjugative means not continuous vertices of a polygon is called diagonal. Any line segment which connects the two non-conjugative vertices of a polygon is called a diagonal. Now see, in this triangle, how many sides are here? 3 sides. Here, there is no non-conjugative vertices. In this triangle, there is no non-conjugative vertices. So, we cannot make diagonal. So, here in this triangle, 0 diagonals. Now, see quadrilateral. Now, here non-conjugative vertices here. So, opposite of this. So, we can draw a diagonal here. From this point to here, we can draw a diagonal. So, here quadrilateral, how many sides are there? 4 sides. So, we can draw 2 diagonals. Pentagon, 5 sides are there, 5 diagonals. Hexagon, 6 sides are there, 9 diagonals. So, this is the formula to remember how many diagonals we can make in the given polygon. So, relation to find the number of diagonals. Okay, n into n minus 3 whole divided by 2. Now, you suppose you see here in triangle there are totally 3 sides are there. So, n value you should take 3. Here 3 minus 3. So, 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay. So, 0 into 3, that is 0, 0 by 2, that is total it becomes 0. That means here no diagonals, that is 0 diagonals. Now, see in this quadrilateral, 4 sides are there. Now, 4, n equal to, you should take 4. 4 minus 3, that is 1. Here n is there, 4. 4 divided by 2, that is equal to 2. That means 2 diagonals. So, in this same way, you can remember how many diagonals we can draw in a given polygon. First, you have to think that how many sides are there. Depend upon that sides. Then, we can use this formula n into n minus 3 whole divided by 2. We can find how many diagonals we can draw in the given polygon. Next point, interior and exterior of a closed curve. Interior and exterior of a closed curve. Now you see here, the shaded part represents the interior. This shaded part represents the interior. And exterior of the closed curve. Exterior means outside, exterior of the closed curve. This outer part, this black dark one, it is said to be a exterior. So, this part is said to be interior, and here this part is said to be exterior. Convex and concave polygons. The polygons which have all the diagonals inside the figure are known as a convex polygon. So, in this convex polygon, all the diagonals should be inside the figure. Then it is said to be a convex polygon. A polygon which have some of its diagonals outside the figure also are known as a concave polygon. Now in this figure, one diagonal is outside the figure. So this type of polygon is said to be a concave polygon. Concave polygon. Next point, we'll go to regular and irregular polygons. Polygons which are equiangular and equilateral are called regular polygons, that is polygon in regular if its all sides are equal, its all angles are equal. Regular polygon which are equiangular and equilateral. You see here in this triangle all the three sides are equal. If all the three sides are equal, then all angles are equal. Now here square, all the four sides are equal, all four angles are equal. Okay, so these two types of figures are said to be regular polygon. When it become regular polygon, its all sides are equal and its all angles are equal. Now see here, polygons that are not regular. So these two polygons are not regular. Why it is not regular? Here only these two opposite sides are equal, but here these two are not equal. So here in this triangle here all sides are not equal. So this type of polygons are said to be not regular polygon. Okay, now hence square is a regular polygon, but a rectangle is not, as its angles are equal but its sides are not equal. Okay, in this rectangle all angles are equal but sides are not equal. Okay.